हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास क्लास 9 चैप्टर 4 ऑग्लियरीज। टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट मोडल ऑग्लियरीज। वी नो मोडल्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस 13 मोडल्स आर देयर एंड विल, वुड, शैल, शुड, कैन, कुड, मे, माइट, यू मस्ट, नीड, डेयर, यूज टू, ऑट टू। And the use of modals depends on the mood of the speaker. And most of the students confuse which modal to use and how to use the modals. I think we shall try to have a clear-cut discussion about modals. Let us discuss auxiliaries. In the last session, we have already discussed primary auxiliaries, we have to. In this session, we shall discuss about modal auxiliaries or modals. We know most of the students confuse how, when and how to use modals. The use, form and function of modals, the use of modals is sometimes students confuse or find it difficult to use. So, I think we shall try our best to make it a clear-cut idea. Okay, so let us discuss first what is auxiliary. Auxiliary, an auxiliary verb always comes before the main verb to indicate its tense or modalities of expression, like expression of ability, permission, compulsion, obligation, threat, desirability, etc. Auxiliaries are of two types. They are primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. We know we have do at the primary auxiliaries. We have already clear discussed in the last session. Modal auxiliaries we know are 13. We know to our knowledge. Will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might. These are pair modals. Must, ought to, need, dare, used to. So 13 modals are there. So let us discuss one by one their uses. Shall, will. You know now in the present English style, will is more used. The use of shall is less in modern English. The modal shall is used with first person I and we to express plain future, permission, promise, order, offer, etc. When shall takes a subject other than I and we, it means a threat or compulsion. You take the example, shall plan for plain future. We shall be back in an hour's time. Here shall means a plain future. We are talking about the plain future. When we think of permission, taking permission or giving permission, seek permission or give permission, shall. For example, shall I go home now? Shall is also used for seeking permission here. And we also use shall for promise. Promise, I shall take you out on Monday. This is for promise. Order also, you shall not use my bicycle again. This is order. Here, the subject is second person. In case we can use threat or order, that is threat or compulsion, that is a second person or third person. You shall not use my bicycle again. And when we can also use shall, for offer, shall I give you a cup of tea? So these are the uses of shall. Let us discuss will. Now the use of will is more and more. The, we use will with the second person and third person mostly. The modal will is usually used to express the meaning of plain future, willingness, request and prediction. First, let us take the example of plain future. Will, Ben will be 14 next week. This is very plain future, simple future. And we also use will with the meaning of willingness or promise. I'll do it for you. This is my promise. Here the subject is first person, I. And we use I or will with the first person in case of with the meaning of willingness or promise. I'll do it for you. And a request or order we can also use for the meaning request. Will you do me a favor? This is a request.
And also, will is used for prediction. He will come in time. That is, this is prediction. We predict he will come in time. So let us discuss should and ought to. We know there is similarity between should and ought to. The modal auxiliary should is generally used to give advice or to express obligation. First, let us discuss how should is used in the meaning of advice. You should consult a doctor. You should see a doctor because you are sick. So, should is mostly used with the meaning of advice. Should can be used with the meaning of also wish. For the example, I should like to be a teacher. This is my wish. I should like to be a doctor. And should is also used for the meaning of a duty or necessity. You should do this assignment. This is a necessity. This is your duty. You should do the homework. We can also use should for the meaning obligation. You should vote in favor of any candidate. You like or do not. You should vote in favor of any candidate. This is for obligation. So let us discuss ought. You know, ought to is almost similar to should in meaning, but is used in its place. And is used in its place, but ought to is a stronger expression than should, and it is used when there is a moral obligation or when obligation comes from outside. This is the difference. When the obligation is from inside, we can use should, and when the obligation is from outside, we use ought to. Or duty or obligation. Take the example. I ought to get more exercise. I ought to get more exercise means I am physically unfit. My doctor advised me to do. So this compulsion, this obligation comes from the doctor. So we use ought to. I ought to get more exercise. They ought to ban smoking in public places because there is a rule. Government pins, government prohibition rules are there. This is ought to is used because obligation is from outside. Okay. But you should or ought to wash your hands before you eat. So this obligation does not come from outside. So we can use both should or ought to because the meaning remains the same. You should wash your hands before you eat. Or you ought to wash your hands before you eat, meaning the same. Okay, we have already discussed that means should, the use of should and ought to, very similarity is there. Sometimes some difference, little difference is there. Let us discuss would and used to. The modal auxiliary would is, there is also similarity and some dissimilarity is there. The modal auxiliary would is usually used to express request, invitation, probability, or past habit. We use would for polite request. It is more polite. Would you pass me the salt? This is polite request. And we use would for seeking permission or giving permission. I would not allow my sons to do that. This is giving permission. And we can also use for the meaning of probability. He would be at home now. This is probability. He would be at home now. This is probability. We can also use would for willingness. I would do that for you. And we can also use would for a past habit. When I was young, I would swim 5 hours a day. Okay. But let us discuss used to. We use would for past habit. We also used to for past habit. But difference is there. The modal used to also expresses a past habit. And it does not have an equivalent for present habit. We cannot use used to with an expression of a definite period of time. If definite period of time is there, we can use would. If definite period of time is not there, you should use used to. I used to go to school in my village when I was a child. Okay. But I went to school in my village for 5 years, because definite period of 5 years is there, so we can't use to here. Past simple is used. Okay, so we have already discussed the use of would and used to. So let us discuss can and could. Can and could as a modal auxiliary can usually means one's ability to do something or possibility, give or seek permission. Let us discuss the use of can with the meaning ability. He can run like a deer. This is his ability to do. Possibility also, the leopard can be hiding in the bush. This is possibility. The snake can be hiding in that bush. This is possibility. Give or seek permission. You can come with me. You can come with me tomorrow. This is giving permission. You can come with me tomorrow. You can go with me. This is giving permission. Seeking permission. Can I use your bicycle? This is seeking permission. So in case of give or seek permission, we use can. Can is also used for request. How? Can you lend me 100 rupees? Can you lend me 5 rupees? Okay. So let us discuss could. Could is used for past ability or the past of can. He could write poems when he was only 10. When I was a child, I could write a bike. Okay. Polite request also, could is used for polite request. Could I come out with my brothers are? And could can be also used for possibility. What he says could be true. Here could means possibility. What he says could be true. Here the meaning of could here is a possibility. So let us discuss may and might. In order to give or seek permission, may is used. It also means a factual possibility or expression of a wish. Let us discuss give or seek permission. When you are outside the class, you can say, ask your teacher, may I come in, sir? May I come in, sir? So may here is asking for give or seek permission. You may come in now, giving permission. So may is used for giving permission or seeking permission. May can be used also possibility. Mother may be in the kitchen, but the possibility is very factual. Okay. And let may can be used for the meaning of wish. May God bless you. May God bless you. We usually say to our friends or relatives, may God bless you. Here may means wish. Might suggest a very remote possibility. You know, may is a factual possibility, means more possibilities there. But might is a less possibility. Mother may be in the kitchen. That means more possibilities there. But in case of who might, less possibilities there, remote possibility there. It may also mean a past purpose. You see, what you say might be true. That means less possibilities there, remote possibilities there. So might is less possible, may is more possible. Okay. And it can be also used as a past purpose. He died that other might live. Here past purpose. Okay. So let us discuss need and dare. These two modal auxiliaries are usually used only in negative and interrogative sentences. Okay. Need and dare. They can be used as a full verbs. So they are semi-modals. They can be used as a full verbs. They can be used as a modals also. But these two modals, need and dare, are usually used only in negative and interrogative sentences. Okay, take the example. I am not deep. You need not speak so loudly. Here need is used in interrogative negative sentence. I dare not ask my teacher to leave for leave. He may be angry. So here dare is used in negative sentence. Dare you do this? Here dare is used in interrogative. Need you leave the party so soon? This is need is also used in interrogative. We know need and dare are usually used in negative and interrogative sentences. Okay. Like do auxiliary. okay, or dummy auxiliary. So let us discuss must. This modal expression must is a strong obligation, necessity, compulsion, or a logical conclusion. So it is used for recommendation, persuasion, prohibition, or inference. Let us discuss must used for obligation. I must write the answer before I go. This is obligation. He must do his homework regularly. This is obligation, compulsion. Okay. And logical conclusion, he must be mad to do this. He is absent today. He must be at home. He must be ill. Logical conclusion. And must not is used for prohibition. You must not touch a live fire. Where? You must not touch fire. You must not smoke here in the public places. Okay. So, must not is used for prohibition. So, I think we have discussed the use of modals. Let's not do the activities. Activity 1. Fill the blank, choosing the right modal given in the brackets. Dare I go home, sir? Can I go home, sir? How dare you say so? I am here. You need not speak. What you say cannot be true. You need not come tomorrow. He has already come. You must not post the letters. Accidents may happen in coal mines. He must not have been 50 then. Okay. Let us do activity 2. Fill in the blank with suitable modals. He will come in time. She would be at home now. I used to go to school in my village when I was a child. Hitesh can run like a deer. He could write poems when he was only 10. May I come in, sir? He died that others might live. You need not speak so loudly. How dare you challenge me? You must not touch a live fire. I think you have a clear-cut idea about modals. Okay. So, what we have discussed, let us do some of. Okay. We have already discussed in the both the lessons about verbs. We know verbs are of two types. Some of them are main verbs or lexical verbs or full verbs. And others are auxiliary verbs or helping verbs. Auxiliary verbs are of two types. Primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Primary auxiliaries are be, have, do. And modal auxiliaries or modals are of two types. Some of them paired verbs and some others are single verbs. Pair verbs are will, would, shall, should, may, might, can, could. 8 modals are paired modals. Okay. Single verbs, pure, some of them are pure modals and some of them are semi-modals. We know must or to. The paired modals will, would, shall, should, may, might, can, could, must, or to. These are pure modals because they cannot be used as main verb or full verb. But need, dare, and used, they are semi-modals because they can be used as full verb or main verb sometimes. So we have already discussed about auxiliaries. Okay. Thank you. Best o'clock.